I will say something about the TED Talk. TED Talk is a new addition, as Jan mentioned, that the LeanDot infrastructure. It is an online environment for corpora that is used for the searches in at LeanDot, and currently also maintained at LeanDot, despite the fact that it wasn't originally developed there. It was originally developed in Portugal. And it is a multi-purpose tool that tries to serve a rich array of different corpus types. From the perspective of computational linguistics, which is what LeanDot mostly does, it is an online interface to the popular Corpus Workbench corpus tool, and as such, very comparable to Context, which you will see later, or Corpuscle, or CQP Web, or various other tools. But different from the vast majority of those, it has two very different ideas behind it. The first is it tries to not do any kind of document cleanup. That is to say, anything that is in the original data should be kept because it might be important. So that includes things like type settings or gaps in the data, or anything that is in the original data should be kept because it might be important. And we don't just search data, we also try to visualize corpus documents. So each document is a collection corpus is a collection of documents, and each document can be visualized amicably. Documents are stored in the popular and highly used TI-XML format with inline annotations. And in that sense, it's actually less comparable with something like CQP Web and more comparable to something like the online interface to Esmeralda or the EVT, which is I can't remember what the abbreviation stands for. So on the one hand, we want to serve rich data. And on the other hand, we also want to make corpora editable. That is to say, we want to make the makers of the corpora are responsible for their own corpus. It shouldn't be the case that somebody makes a corpus and after that computational linguists take care of putting it online, because that means that any kind of error in the corpus would always have to be done corrected by the computational team, which isn't the most ideal way of working. So the idea is that people that make a corpus can simply correct errors in their corpus while they're using it themselves. And they can even transcribe documents directly inside TED Talk. It keeps the original formatting by doing inline tokenization, which is hardly a new idea, but there aren't that many tools that actually do it. So the input is in principle a TI XML document, which can either be created directly in TED Talk, or it can be converted from a range of different input formats, for which we have an online converter tool. And the tokenization is then done on top of the TI XML file without throwing anything away, which means we put a node around all the tokens in the corpus, and we then put annotations on top of those nodes. The searchable part of it is, as I mentioned, the Corpus Workbench, but that is actually a derived product. So the Corpus Workbench corpus isn't the actual corpus. It is just a corpus that is created for the purpose of searching the data. All annotation is directly done in TI XML, and the CWB corpus is from time to time simply updated based on the TI XML files. So here's a small example as to how it works in practice. You have a sentence like, this is some small example which contains some bold and some italics, but it could be any other kind of markup. And the traditional way of handling a sentence like that would be to get rid of the bold and get rid of the italics, split it into words, and run computational tools on it. But as I said, the bold and the italics might be important, so we don't want to do that. So rather, we convert it first to TI XML, as you can see in the second line, where we put the proper XML codes around it to indicate where the bold and the italics are. Then we put token nodes inside that TI XML, and then we put annotations on top of that, as you can see in the final line of this slide. Doing that means that we can actually display the original data. So this is a screenshot of the example that you just saw inside the TED Talk environment, where you see that there is some bold, that the italics is also still there. And if you move your mouse over the dot, you see that it's marked as a punctuation mark with the lemmatization as well, according to the universal dependencies standards, although you could use any other standard as well. So this takes care of the part of visualizing rich data. And the editing is in principle done extremely simply. If as a user, you notice that some part of the tagging went wrong, the only thing you have to do is you don't have to open some text-based file and look for the error. You just click on the word that is wrong and it will open a small edit window for you where you can type in the corrected form. Here there is no error, but if there would be an error in the word small, it would, for instance, not be an adjective, but a noun, you could simply correct it here. So while you're working with the data and see them in full editable format, you can also click on words and edit them directly. The searching, as I mentioned, is done in the Corpus Workbench, and the way that it's done is a script goes through all the TI-XML files and builds a corpus from those data. While doing that, it also keeps track of where all the tokens were found in which file. And after that, you can search using the corpus query language, as it's called, to run complex queries on the corpus and find where in the corpus your query is actually found. But rather than outputting the direct output of the Corpus Workbench, the system actually looks up the original XML fragment and displays the XML fragment. So what you see in the quick line is not a sequence of tokens, it is rather a fragment of XML, which means that everything that is in the original XML is also made visible. That on the one hand contains things like typesetting, so you see the bolds in bold and the italics in italics, but it also has some side effects. For instance, in traditional corpora, if you use a French corpus, the word O will always be split into A and Le, which for copying the example, for instance, for teachers is quite dreadful because it looks quite bad in French if you split O into A and Le. Since we're seeing XML here, the splitting isn't actually done. The tagging is done inside the orthographic forms. And what you see is simply the word O. And it knows that O consists of two grammatical words. On the one hand, the preposition A, and on the other hand, the determiner Le. So in that sense, the Corpus Workbench in TiTalk works as an index over the TI-XML files. You can use it to directly find things in the original TI-XML files. And then if you find an error, you can also directly correct them, as I mentioned. TiTalk has a very modular design. Like I said, we want to visualize corpora, but not all corpora are the same. There is a very different need for, say, a spoken corpus or for a manuscript-based corpus or for a map-based interface. So depending on the type of corpus, TiTalk can visualize it differently. And importantly, all those modules work on exactly the same TI-XML files. So you can use any of those modules for any of the corpora in TiTalk. Of course, some of them will have requirements. If, for instance, you want to do something map-based, then you need to, of course, have map data. If you want to do tree banks, then of course, there need to be dependencies because otherwise you can't visualize that. So I want to now simply show some examples, screenshots of different corpora and TiTalk with their interface. Starting with this one, which is one of the newest ones. Here you see a waveform-based interface to a spoken corpus, where on the top you see the waveform. It's actually a video, so the waveform is the audio corresponding to the video. And if you play the audio, it will scroll the transcription that you see below it and will actually play the video and the audio. So you get a full speech-based interface for corpora if there are, if it's a time-aligned corpus like this one. And if there are indications of pauses, repetitions, truncations, and God knows what else, all of those will be visualized as well. This particular example doesn't have any of those, so they're not shown here. This is converted from a subtitle document. Not all the interfaces are actually based on linguistic data. This is a recent addition that we also made, which actually shows an interface to corpora based on named entities. So you don't see the part of speech tag markup in this particular interface. What you see here is actually the named interfaces, in this case, from the European Holocaust Research Infrastructure, as an example. where it can actually show for all the named entities in the document what they mean, and all this information comes from an external XML file in this case. Yet another example is this one. This is one of the first Spanish documents, the Cantigas de Santa Maria, where you see that the document in this case is actually aligned with the manuscript, and you see a line of the manuscript and below it the line of the the transcription. This is not done by actually cutting out things manually. This is simply done by bounding box information. So all this is dynamically generated from the underlying XML files. You can, if you have map coordinates, you can do map-based searches. This is, for instance, an example of a comparison between the word mulher and the word mujer in half Spanish, half Portuguese corpus. And not surprisingly, you see that the word mujer is used in Portugal and the word mujer is used in Spain, because mujer is Spanish and mujer is Portuguese. So in this case, this way you can do, say, dialect-based searches on a map for dialect corpora. And as the last example here, you have an interface to dependency tree banks, where on the top you see the full XML in TiTalk of the sentence, and below it you see a representation of the tree, of the dependency tree in this case. All the words in the tree are linked to the words in the sentence, as you can see by moving your mouse over the word quarto in this case, which shows the information where in the sentence it occurs, and also what the part of the tree stack and the lemma of the word are. So TiTalk is a tool that is used, in, as you can guess from the examples, in quite a few corpora around the world. There's about 100 different projects using the tool in about 20 different universities around the world, not only in the Czech Republic, but also, for instance, in Portugal and Spain. And we're, for instance, also trying to install it currently in the French Humanum infrastructure. And typically it's used as a full tool. So it takes care of the corpus searching, of the visualization. But at Lindat, we furthermore it also use it as a back office for other tools. So we have integrated TiTalk at Lindat with both context and PMLTQ, so that from the context interface, you can actually get to the TI XML underlying by a direct link between the context corpus and the TiTalk corpus. So in that sense, for the infrastructures that have their own search tools and want to maintain those, you can also use TiTalk as a visualization framework underneath existing corpus tools. For instance, the context corpus tool that will be shown in the next presentation. That's it for here.